One of the most common questions I get about the Rodecaster Pro is, can you use the Rodecaster to switch between video sources? And my answer for the past 2 years has been no, it's an audio mixer. But Rode has now released new beta firmware version 2.1.2, which includes the ability for the Rodecaster to act as a MIDI controller. This is probably one of the biggest things I've seen. I hope this makes its way to the final version. So having the Rodecaster act as a MIDI controller basically means that via USB, the sound pads can trigger MIDI controlled effects on different applications throughout your computer. Now on the download page for the firmware, which you just download the new companion app, open it up, and then it will update your Rodecaster to the beta. And of course, this is all beta firmware, so you beta believe that things could change in time. And Rode also actually published guides about setting up MIDI with streaming software, OBS on PC specifically. And that's because they tell you how to download a MIDI application that will let you map out keystrokes for PC and OBS. But I got a little tired of the BS of OBS, and so I have been using Ecamm Live since last summer. So when it comes to using MIDI, Mac users are kind of stuck in the mid-eel of not being able to use this super new feature. Until right now, because I totally figured it out. So here's how you use the Rodecaster to switch scenes or whatever other functions you want in Ecamm Live. So the first thing you need to do is install the beta firmware on the Rodecaster, and after that you go into the advanced audio options, click on operations, and you will see an option to enable MIDI control. Make sure that that is enabled. Once you've got the new beta firmware installed, you can go to this website right here, elmc.app. You can download a free trial so you can check it out, see if it works for you, or you can download the full license, which is $25. And now as you can see, I have Ecamm Live and ELMC open on my computer. If I want to change something to do with scenes, I can click refresh and it will bring in all of my scenes from Ecamm. And let's see, there's a few that I want to look at. Mine are kind of a mess right now. I'm going to use the countdown, which is my main thing. So when I do a stream, there's a countdown that pops up. It looks something like this. And then my second scene is just my default scene, which is just my main camera or whatever I have selected with the ATEM. So countdown, I'm gonna find that here. It's got a typo in it, who cares? We're gonna click on sync, and then we're gonna import that. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna import all the overlays and all the things that I have with that scene in here. And now, if you notice, the sync button for countdown is a slightly different color from the other ones, that means it's had everything imported. I'm gonna go down to the bottom and find my default scene and sync that one. And now to program the Rodecaster is super easy. Down here on the bottom, I'm gonna select the Rodecaster. It will only show up down here if you already have MIDI turned on in the Rodecaster settings. And now setting up the control couldn't be easier. So on the countdown, I'm gonna click this little edit button and I'm gonna click MIDI learn. And then I'm just gonna press the sound pad on the Rodecaster that I want. In my case, I'm gonna press sound pad 1. If I press MIDI learn, it says listening for new MIDI, but sometimes that stays up there for a long time and sometimes it only stays up there for a second. You need that to be on there when you're pressing the key. So make sure that's there and then you press the key that you want to assign. Like I mentioned, this is beta firmware and this is just the quickest way I found to be able to map the Rodecaster sound pads to Ecamm Live. So now I've got sound pad 2 set up as my default scene, which is this scene right here, and I've got sound pad 1 set up as my countdown, my like pre-show. So if I press sound pad 1, this pops up right here. And if I press sound pad 2, it goes away. So now I'm switching between my scenes using the Rodecaster Pro. This is just the quickest way I found to map the sound pads to Ecamm Live. Important note though, when you trigger the sound pads to change a scene or a camera or add an overlay or whatever you've programmed them to do, they will still play the sound effect that's attached to them. So you might need to mute your sound pad audio so that way the sound effects aren't just playing every time you change a scene. Obviously it would be nice to be able to fix that and separate those things. So maybe in the full release of the firmware, there's a way to do that where the actual playing of the sound pads isn't connected to the MIDI control of the sound pads. Also, Rode has not talked about using this on a Mac at all. It's just something I kind of pieced together as best I could because this is such an exciting feature. So even though it's imperfect, hey, look at this, I can add stuff and take it away using the Rodecaster Pro. I'm so excited that Rode is leaning in towards embracing the streaming capabilities of the Rodecaster, because I think that is such a great use for it. And I think that's where they're just packing more and more cool value into this thing. So hope that's helpful. Good luck. Remember, it's all beta stuff, so there's gonna be some problems. But if you want things that are a little more polished without problems, check out these Rodecaster Pro videos right here.